Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind as brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon. And we are starting, as is appropriate, with Cliff Racer harassment. Okay, so we're looking for a thing. We're looking for the Dunirai Caverns, southeast of Ghost Gate. And that is apparently all that we know about them. So let's hit up our map. We found a crypt last time and I kind of rolled through it, so I'm figuring that they're probably closer up into like this region up here than necessarily as far south as we are. So I think we're gonna kind of work our way back north here, or at least we're at least gonna try to do the aggro range on these cliff racers. I think that is the problem with them. It's not that there's so many of them, it's that their aggro radius is just so much larger than pretty much every other monster in this game, and so they are just constantly harassing you. And I'm absolutely certain that it's because they fly around, so you know, they need to be able to aggro onto the player from the sky, but the problem is that they do, and then they aggro on the player from literally everywhere else. Take heed, game devs. Your flying creatures, if you want them to aggro on the player, make them swoop down or something every so often. Give them some behavior that, oh hey look, it's a cliff racer, right? It sees like a rat or something, so it swoops down and eats it. There, now they have a reason to be near the ground to attack the player. Don't just be like, no, they're assholes that will aggro you from a kilometer out. That strains disbelief, and it also pisses me off. So quit it. Oh, Ghost Gate, you no longer glow as you once did. Okay, I'm just kind of keeping an eye out for, like, anything. Well, that's something right there. Let's find out what. Oh, are you guys bandits? Are you lurking?
Are you No. My duty to help those less fortunate than myself.
All right, well, I brought a friend. Several. Actually, there. I got you guys dinner. I hope you like it.
What assistance do you need?
Actually, no, of course, you can't tell me where this place that I'm looking for is, because that would be helpful.
Dunmer? What do you want?
Screw off, Cliff Racer Corpse. Other Cliff Racer Corpse. Yeah. Well, you guys are both useless then. What a shame. We can't go evil yet. We have to wait until I've beaten Tribunal before I can go and test my prowess against the city guard. With as mountainous as this area is, you'd think that there would be caves just everywhere. But instead all we get are cliff racers and shulks. Screw off, Beetle. I'm questing for the Fighters Guild. Yes, I am thinking very, hey, acrobatics. I am thinking pretty strongly that once we're done with the Fighters Guild, I'm just gonna move on to Tribunal, because these quests are meant for someone that is much lower level than I am, and like, this is not exactly the most interesting thing to do in the world. You know, go kill bandits, go kill necromancers, go kill bandits, deliver some booze, go kill bandits, find and kill a necromancer, escort this asshole from A to B, kill some bandits, and escort some booze. It's like, eh. You know, come on. I understand you gotta have, like, your basic quests. Oh, you guys are hostile. Alright. Oh. Whoa! I'm juking! Oh, where am I going? You don't even know. My air control is off the hook. What have they done? They have drained my strength. You fools! Yeah, about that. Oh, do you have anything? No. I don't know, but as I was saying, I understand that there need to be, like, basic quests, and I certainly have no problem with that, but stuff like this, you know, I think that this kind of stuff would be better on having, like, a bounty board as side things you can do. Because, like, these aren't really, You know, they're all the same. I don't want to say they're not interesting, because, I mean, they've all been fairly unique. Like, I mean, we went to a mine and the thing was overrun by Nyx hounds. Like, that's unique. I'm not complaining about that. It's just that a lot of these feel kind of like busy work, and I don't remember enough about the guilds in Oblivion or Skyrim to be like, well, they didn't have this. I'm fairly certain that Oblivion had some busy work quests in it. But I also remember there being some really cool ones too. Like Mage's Guild quests where you're, you know, going into a guy's dreams and stuff. Although I think the Fighter's Guild quests were all pretty kind of cut and dry. You guys, yeah, I was gonna say, are you guys more bandits? And you are. Yeah. Oh, and there's another one, all right. Paralysis. Oh, she resisted. Sneaky woman. She hit me with a burden spell, I think. Some gold. But yeah, it's like, I don't know. I'm okay with like quests that are, you know, go and kill some bandits every once in a while. That's, you know, certainly, there's certainly nothing wrong. I'm not saying that these are bad quests. I wanna, because I know there are gonna be some people out there that think that this game can do no wrong. And I don't necessarily want them, you know, freaking out, thinking that I'm slighting it. I don't think these are bad quests. I just think that there are too many of them. Like, okay, I can go to a couple places and kill bandits, but when the majority of your quests are go to places and kill bandits or kill necromancers, it's kind of old. Oh, seriously? Is this the... Oh, if this is the mine with these two assholes, I'm gonna be pissed. Duniri? Is that what we're looking for? I'm pissed. I'm pissed. I'm mad. I'm raging. You guys can't see it, but I'm raging. We brought your alcohol, you jerks. Who am I delivering this to? Nelikar. All right. The only downside is that, like, I can't really complain because it's Fighter's Guild quest. You're not exactly gonna get, you know, a bunch of stuff that's crazy in a Fighter's Guild, because, you know, you hire them to go and fight. So I can't be, you know, whinging that as a fighter, I'm going around and fighting a lot. So I don't know. Let's see, you are not who I'm looking for. It's probably none of these guys. These guys all just look like workers. I'm probably looking for somebody in a robe. Like you. What a twist.
What assistance do you need?
I brought you booze. Take it. Good, the miners will be happy to have some fresh sujama. Personally, I cannot understand how anyone would drink this foul stuff. I prefer Valenwood wine myself. You would! Freaking high elves. Okay, I'm gonna quick save just in case because we've been having some bugs with this portion of the world. And we are gonna turn this in. I don't think I forgot about these either. Hey there, buddy. Let's see here. Can I just do... No, I probably have to ask him about the caverns. Good work. Here's 500 septums to cover your trouble. It's the best I can do for this type of contract. Advancement. Ah. Orders? I have a contract to assist another Imperial researcher. Oh god, I need someone to escort Sandale of Shimmerine. Great. Tell me about her. Go to Talacero, which is between Saran and the Siltstrider port near Molagmar. Speak with Sandale Cimmerane and escort her through the Tolacero. She lacks the field experience of Loriana Macrina, so she'll likely need more protection. Oh, that's great. That's great. Didn't the other chick die because she elected to throw herself into some lava?
Speak.
Taking these back. The only thing I hate more than escorting booze is escorting people, because people are stupid. Especially in this. That's okay. We'll make do with it. I have copious quick saves. Outside. And find this place. I'm gonna have to figure out how to get there, you know, quickly, but I think we'll be okay. Let's see, meet me there. Telsera's between Saran and the Siltstrider part of Molagmar. So Saran is, wait, Molagmar is, I thought over here. There's Molagmar. There's Saran. So yeah, it's, you know, just this chunk of land. All right. See, if I do an CV, it'll take me to Alderaan. And I can just go from Alderaan to Saran, I think. So I think that's what we're gonna do. Man, it is made so much easier. If I couldn't cast stuff like teleportation magic, I would probably be complaining a lot more about the overland travel than I do. It is, thankfully, like, it's something that's readily available, though. That's the thing, is like, you know, if you can't do this, it's your own damn fault. Oh, this actually took us to Malagmar. That's convenient. All right. But yeah, it's, you know, very much like you can go to a temple and buy scrolls to get you there, and with money being what it is, even in the later game, you know, it's not too hard to come across items that are worth a decent bit of coin. So it's like, yeah, if you're not using the teleportation magic, you know, you're it's your own damn fault. This game's got fast travel in it. You've just got to think to use it. It's not clicking on map icons like it is in the later ones. Okay, so here's the Silt Strider port. And is this what we're looking for? Thank God they just plopped it down on our map. It would be quicker to just, I wonder if we can just Silt Stride to Saran and walk from there. I think it's like a map square closer, but you know, every little bit. Hey there. Yes. Convenient, and it cost me a whopping 12 gold. I wonder, I wanna check something. I was gonna say, once we get here. Let's see. No. I was wondering if they maybe tracked how much money you spent on Silt Striders and traveling stuff. That'd be kind of an interesting figure. I'd be curious to see, you know, just how much money I've spent on fast travel in this. I can't imagine it would be, you know, a crazy amount of money. Like, realistically, I'd probably say, I don't know, by this point in time, maybe a couple thousand septums, not, you know, too ridiculous amounts. All right, is this all I'm gonna be able to, yeah, this is all I'm gonna be able to be clever about here before we have to throw some magic. I'll just go the swift one. And up we go! Action gameplay. I know you guys love my levitation. Oh, we're actually gonna need two castings, I'm surprised. That's probably because I cast the swift version. We would have probably been able to get up here with a 30 second, slightly slower moving version. That's okay. Oh, and it's just straight this way. And we'll just eat some falling damage here because acrobatics. Oh, that was actually, you know, a little bit of damage. I'm surprised. It'll probably be healed up by the time we get there because of our regeneration shirt or whatever it is. This can't be it right here. You're not gonna attack me. I don't even know why I pulled my sword. No, all right. Yeah, it's just an egg mine. I say, I don't even know why I pulled the sword out. I'm just so used to being ambushed by freaking cliff racers at all times. It's my default reaction. Oh no. Am I gonna have to escort this person through one of these keeps? No, this could be bad. Is this, oh please, oh please, please, please. No, it is. All right, we have a note from, oh no, this is a note from her, I think, yes. Looks safe, went down to scout it out. I'm quick saving. You can't see it, I'm just sitting here shaking my head. Let's see what we got. Looks safe, yeah man, what with the Ash Lords and stuff. Ah! Cultists, uh-oh. Oh no, okay. Was that game lock up on me for a second there? I don't know what that was. Arr, Ash Ghoul. Quit throwing darts, you dicks! I wonder if... screw it. Haha! Damn it. What are you gonna do now? You guys are fucking boned. Get out of my way. I'm trying to... There we go. Howdy. Yeah, where are you going? You jerk. Freaking dreamers, I killed your master. Your darts are worthless. Killed your master and I'll kill you too. Alright. So which of these doors do you think we're gonna find her mutilated corpse behind? Whoa, hey, Ascended Sleeper. I don't think I have any empty greater soul gem or grand soul gems, so... Sadly... Can't do anything with that. It'd be really cool if you cast, like, a soul trap on something and you didn't necessarily have a gem on you, that it would just funnel the energy from it into, like, your magical items that need charges. That would just be convenient. I think that would probably make me use magic items a lot more, like, especially in the later games. So a mechanic like that, I think, would make it a lot more, I guess, accessible, you know, casual and making the game less hardcore, yada, yada, yada. That's what some people would say. I say it's just getting rid of some busy work. I'm all for games being hardcore, but I am not all for games just having a bunch of fucking busy work in them. Kind of a bunch of junk potions here. I'm gonna leave them because our carrying capacity is quite high. Well, we are carrying a lot of shit. And I don't necessarily want to be running around picking up potions that I'm never gonna use. I'm sure I'm running around with a bunch of them as is. I also need to drop some of this gear that I'm trolling around with. Oh man, I'm gonna laugh. It'd be cool if this were like an assassination attempt or something. Are either of you guys? No, alright. It'd be cool if this were an assassination attempt, like they're just luring guild members here to kill them. Nope. Hey, rat. Oh no, don't tell me. Don't tell me this is her. Alright, that's her. She's stuck in a room with a rat. I'm clearing this place out before we move on. I do not want this woman near me.
You will die.
I do not want this woman near me while there are dangers present. Looks like if we're back here. Because, yeah, she's gonna end up running away and getting stabbed to death by me. Especially with an ascended sleeper floating around. This thing probably, like, disintegrate her or something. Like, itch my nose. What do we have here? Corpus meat. Delicious, delicious corpus meat. Okay, let's see. Let's see what this woman wants. Is this all just... Man, this is think about this. This is some dark shit right here. Chunks of, like, plague flesh in basins for people to eat. So what do we have here? A silver viper sword, detect enchantments, expensive shirt, healing, breathing water, sure. It's probably like swim if I, oh, there's a well-locked chest in here. There's a well-locked chest and one that we can probably actually pick. Might be able to pick them both. We'll try. I'm not hopeful. Because, yeah, this 20 is giving us enough trouble. I don't know if it'll tell us that it's impossible for us to pick. I don't think it will. I'm just going to run this pick out. All right. Oh, wow, we actually got it on the last one there. Nice. 76 gold. That's certainly worth... we put into it. Yeah, and this one has, you know, like 300, 400 gold pieces worth of crap in it. Logic. Oh my god, woman. Wait, what? Is that rat? Did I not kill that thing? Does it spawn one every time I open the door? No. Huh. Alright.
Patience is limited.
Oh, shut up. Are you my guide from the Fighters Guild? I'm sorry I went ahead on my own. Please, let us travel together back outside. Can you guide me back? Sure. Get me out of here. I'm terrified of rats and stuff. Because I'm an elf. And we fear nature. Actually, God, what is it? I think wild elves in the Elder Scrolls, like, they go full cannibal. They've got some hunt thing that they go on, Hercene's Hunt or whatever, where they just eat everything. It's pretty hardcore. Come on. Make sure she's close to me so she travels with me. Alright. Thank you for your help. It looked to me like the place was safe. Yes, clearly. Are we done? Oh. I'm gonna quick save and we're gonna teleport back and I'm gonna see if we're done, because. I don't know.
May each day greet you.
Hey there. Good work. Wow. All right. Good work. Here's 500 septums for the contract. That was actually less painful than I was expecting. Advancement. Orders? Ooh. I have a contract for 2,000 septums for anyone who can bring Angier to justice. He's a Bosmer mercenary for Master Naloth. One of our clients wants him dead. Angier's in Tel Naga, the tower here in Sadrath Mora. Try to avoid the other guards and just kill Angier. We don't need more trouble with House Telvanni. I'll give you half the bounty if you take care of this. Okay. I know what we're doing next time. But for now, we're gonna call it because we're at 20 minutes. That wasn't too bad. I have no complaints about that quest. It was a nice, it turned it on its head. You know, I'll give them that. But I'm gonna call it. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I will catch you all next time, wherein we are going to go and hunt somebody and kill them, because that's what we do. There will probably be guard collateral damage, because that's also what we do. Until then.